Another issue that was hotly contested over the last few weeks. Where are we tonight with the interest? The arbitration cap on police and fire salaries for municipalities.
Well, you know, the report came out, and this is interesting. You know, you've had this guy, Ed Donnelly, I think his name is, who's been talking all this smack about the report and unfair and all the rest of it. I went back to look at the report from the meeting where they voted 4-4. Mm-hmm. Now, the data in the report that we've saved over the last 5 years, $2.9 billion in property taxes through the cap, and that we've saved between the cap and the 2% cap, and that just with the ARB cap alone, we've saved $530 million in police and fire salaries. $530 million. And our police officers are still the second highest paid police officers in America, and our firefighters are the highest paid firefighters in America after the cap has been in place for 5 years. They've had those data points for 6 months. They had the report for a week before the meeting. When they came and asked for the vote in the committee for the report, Mr. Donnelly admitted at the report that he hadn't even read the report.
Okay.
But he wanted more time to put more things into the report. We said, well, how do you know there's something that needs to be in the report if you haven't even read the report? He admitted at the meeting that he hadn't read the report, and he voted no on issuing a report that he hadn't read. So listen, let's understand what this is. This is politics, man. This is bare knuckle union politics where they want the ability to once again get unlimited raises on the backs of the taxpayers. But when their raises have been limited by a 2% cap, they're still the second highest paid police officers in America and the highest paid firefighters in America.
Well, the town still has the ability to go beyond that 2%, but they have to
pay for it.
And in some cases, do they not have to ask voters to approve it?
Right. You can go higher than 2% on your raises to your police officers and firefighters if you want. Then you have to cut services other places to make sure the whole thing's under 2%. Or if you want to go over the 2% cap, you put it to the voters. And if the voters vote yes, then you get to go over the 2% cap. But here's the thing. We don't need to. The average firefighter salary, I think now, is about $98,000 average. And the average police officer's salary is about $99,000 average. That means there are as many police officers making more than $99,000 as there are making less than $99,000. So do we really need them to have even bigger raises? Seems like a pretty good salary, Eric.
What do you think will happen?